I felt nauseous because, you know, I thought, here we go, it's history repeating itself.
For 20 years, Wayne Karakoriakos has been haunted by a drug trial he took part in as a young digger. He never thought he'd see the day defence would do it again.
I went into panic mode. It affected me mentally.
The Townsville veteran participated in a controversial drug trial in the early 2000s during his deployment in East Timor. Back then, the army had faced a major malaria outbreak.
In the first 5 months of that deployment, about 63 soldiers came down with malaria.
The solution was to trial two medications called tafenoquine and mefloquine. The trial was voluntary, but Wayne says taking the drugs was never a choice.
We were told that it was consensual. However, if we didn't sign the paperwork, we would not go. We had no choice. We were voluntold, so you follow orders when you're in defence.
The complaints of more than 100 veterans have sparked multiple inquiries into the drug's side effects and the conduct of defence.
When I was first diagnosed with depression, for example, that was immediately after my exposure to mefloquine.
But findings have largely been favourable towards defence.
Yeah, myself, 20 years I've been suffering with an acquired brain injury, and I still to this day cannot put a claim in regards to the drugs that defence made me take.
It's come as a shock to these veterans to hear that Defence is once again trialling drugs on its personnel, this time for coronavirus. Up to 700 civilian and ADF frontline healthcare workers are wanted as volunteers. They'll be taking chloroquine, an old malaria drug, as a preventative measure against COVID-19.
Chloroquine, the widely used malaria drug being hailed as a possible treatment for coronavirus.
Today is the single biggest advance in our battle against this pandemic, period.
The data are really just at best suggestive.
Chloroquine and a similar drug, hydroxychloroquine, have been touted as possible coronavirus cures by scientists, celebrities and politicians, including US President Donald Trump.
I sure as hell think we ought to give it a try. We have nothing to lose. You know the expression? What the hell do you have to lose?
Both drugs are being tested by researchers around the world, but results have been mixed. In Brazil, a chloroquine study was recently stopped after high doses proved lethal for some patients.
I do not believe that the Australian Defence Force nor our healthcare professionals should be used as guinea pigs in a drug trial.
Federal Liberal MP Philip Thompson is a former soldier. He believes it's not possible for personnel to freely give consent because of the hierarchical command structure of defence.
The trial, I believe, should be stopped. My view is if they want defence to do a trial, then the Chief of Defence Force, the Chief of Army, the Brigade Commanders and all the Generals, they can take the drug trial. They can stand up and do it instead of pushing it downhill to where an 18-year-old, a 20-year-old will be voluntold or feel pressured to have to take these antimalarials.
I think there is great merit in doing these tests and examination and clinical trials across the world.
Infectious diseases physician Professor Mark Pellegrini says international studies on chloroquine so far have not been conclusive, and there are good reasons to proceed with clinical trials here in Australia.
It's critical to examine, I suppose, the efficacy of these drugs in the spectrum of different settings. If it works somewhere in the world, it might not work in Australia, so we need to test in Australia.
Defence declined 730's request for an interview, but in a statement, the Surgeon General confirmed that 42 members from two health units have started the trial. But enrolment is currently on hold due to a lack of community transmission of COVID-19. She said those already taking part will continue the program and can remove themselves at any time.
I think we have to look really carefully at whether military personnel are an appropriate group to be involved in clinical trials at all.
Pharmacology researcher Associate Professor Jane Quinn lost her husband to suicide in 2006 after he was exposed to antimalarials in the British Army. When it comes to trialling chloroquine, she doesn't think the risk is worth the reward.
we are aware that there has been a problematic track record of use of this particular class of drugs by the ADF for clinical trials, and I would have thought that more caution would be being applied before this trial took place.
The ADF has told 730 participation in the trial is entirely voluntary and that there is no pressure coming from defence, command or anyone else for personnel to volunteer.
I really don't want this drug trial to go ahead. As far as we're concerned, any drug trial run by defence has more than a chance to repeat history and fail. Don't bloody do it. Just don't do it.
Hi, I'm Lee Sales. Thanks for watching this story. If you'd like to watch more of 730's stories, they are on the left of your screen. And tap on the button below to subscribe and get the latest from ABC News.